My name is Moss, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to perform screenshot testing on the LambdaTest platform. With screenshot testing, you can automatically capture full page screenshots of your web application on a large variety of browsers, operating systems, and viewports. Let's take a closer look at how screenshot testing works. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is log into LambdaTest and navigate to my dashboard. I'm already logged in, so I'm going to navigate to the dashboard. And to perform screenshot testing, I'm going to expand this left-hand side menu, and then under Visual UI Testing, I'm going to expand that dropdown and select Screenshot. Screenshot testing allows me to take up to 25 screenshots in a single test session. In order to take screenshots, all I have to do is enter my target URL and select my desired configuration across various desktop browsers, mobile platforms, and operating systems. As you can see, I can select various operating system versions across Windows, macOS, and OS X. And for each operating system version that I select, I can select multiple versions across a wide variety of browsers for that operating system. And I can also do the same for mobile platforms and browsers as well. If I wanted to reset my current selection of browsers, I can simply click this button here. I can also save a particular configuration for future screenshot test sessions to one of these three lists. All I have to do is select the target list, make my selection of browsers, and select the star button. And then for future screenshot test sessions, I can simply select the desired list of configurations and they will automatically be selected for me. And I can easily modify what's contained within the list by deselecting the configuration and then pressing the star button again to update the list. For my first test session, I'm going to use LambdaTest.com. And then I'll select my desired configuration. Once I'm ready to take the screenshots, I simply select the capture button. Once the screenshots have been generated, we can select a particular screenshot to review it further. From here, we can review the full page screenshot and then use the tools on the left-hand side menu to annotate the screenshot as well. These annotations are helpful in highlighting bugs that may have appeared during screenshot testing. Additionally, we can also see the target browser, browser version, operating system and operating system version, as well as the viewport. If you'd like to, you can also share this screenshot with your team. You can either email the screenshot or use a shareable link. And set an expiration time for how long the screenshot can be accessed. You can also download this screenshot to your local machine. If a bug was identified in the screenshot, you can utilize the Mark as Bug feature to create a new issue for the bug. When I select the Mark as Bug button, it will prompt me to integrate my LambdaTest account with an external tool that I can share the screenshot with. As you can see, I can integrate my LambdaTest account with tools like Slack and Jira and share this issue with those tools. If I select more integrations, you can see the full list of tools that can be integrated with your LambdaTest account. If you'd prefer not to share this issue with an external tool, you can utilize LambdaTest's issue tracker instead. From this form, I can assign the issue, select the type of issue, select a priority, and provide a summary and description of the issue. Once I select Create Issue, a new issue will be created in LambdaTest's Issue Tracker. In addition to the Mark as Bug feature, you can also save the screenshot to the project that's associated with this test session. It is also possible to download all generated screenshots in a zip file using the Download All button. Alternatively, you can download a PDF file that contains all of the generated screenshots as well. Simply select the Download All PDF button. I can also share all generated screenshots using the Share Screenshots button. This will share all screenshots generated in the test session. If I wanted to reproduce a bug that I found in a particular screenshot, I can select the orange rocket to launch a new real-time test session with the target configuration that the bug was found in. I can also use the down arrow to download this individual screenshot to my local machine. If I select this button, I'll be taken to a list of recently executed test sessions. This page will also list scheduled test sessions that have not been executed yet. In order to schedule a test session, I would simply select my desired configuration and then select this button. From here, I can select the desired time that the test will execute. And I can also choose whether the test session will repeat weekly, monthly, or daily. After I've selected my desired schedule, I can then select Schedule. To view scheduled test sessions, I simply need to visit the Recents page. And from here, you can see the test session that we just scheduled. If your web application requires basic authentication, then you can select the Basic Authentication button to enter your credentials and use them in the test session. In addition, if you need to capture screenshots of your web application from behind its login page, you can add a login profile. In order to add a new login profile, simply select Login, then select New Login. From here, you can enter the login URL. The next step is to locate the elements of the login form. From here, you can select the type of locator for username, password, and your web application's login button. After entering the type of locator and its value, we would then enter our credentials. Finally, we would provide this profile with a name and select Save. In order to utilize our newly created login profile, we would simply need to select Login and then toggle our desired login profile. Let's try this out with the Manage Team URL under my LambdaTest account. I'm going to copy this URL to my clipboard. And back on the screenshot testing page, I'm going to refresh the page to deactivate the basic authentication credentials. I'll then activate the login profile that I just created and paste in the Manage Teams URL in the Target URL field. I'll also select my desired configuration. And just to verify what we would see if we were not logged in, I'll navigate to this URL in an incognito window. As you can see, it takes me to the LambdaTest login page. Let's start the test session and verify that our login profile works. I'll open up the generated screenshot, and from here we can tell that our login profile worked correctly, and we can view my LambdaTest account Manage Team page from behind the login page. Next to the login profiles, we can adjust the preferences of the test session. We can choose to keep the original quality of the screenshots or compress the screenshots. And for mobile viewports, we can select portrait or landscape layout. The defer time will allow us to set a period of time that LambdaTest will wait before taking the screenshot. This gives your web application the chance to fully load before the screenshot is taken. We can also select a target resolution for both OS X and Windows machines. Toggling Smart Scroll on will allow you to ignore all iframes on your page. You can also adjust the client location from this dropdown. And optionally, you can choose to have an email notification sent to you on test completion. It's important to note that you can also perform screenshot testing on your locally hosted websites. To do so, you would need to configure a new tunnel using the Lambda Tunnel application. You can create a new tunnel by simply downloading the tunnel binary file. After extracting the binary file, you would navigate to the binary file's location in your terminal and execute this command. Doing so would create a new tunnel that LambdaTest could use to perform screenshot testing on your locally hosted website. You can also create a new tunnel by downloading the desktop application to your local machine. I'll move the application file to a desired location on my local machine. I'll make the file executable and then run the application in a new terminal window. From here, I would simply provide my LambdaTest account username, access key, and then provide a name for the tunnel. I can retrieve my access key by navigating back to my LambdaTest account and then selecting command line. I'll copy my access key here and navigate back to the application and paste it into the access key field. I can then select launch to create a new tunnel. Since the status of the tunnel is running, I should be able to navigate back to LambdaTest and select the tunnel from the drop-down menu. In the Tunnel drop-down menu, I can now select my newly created tunnel for this test session. And in the top right, we can see that there is one tunnel active, which I can deactivate by simply selecting the red X. Another very important aspect of the screenshot testing feature is its RESTful API. Let's take a look at the API reference documentation. I'm going to navigate to my account dropdown and then open up the Help Center in a new tab. On the left-hand side menu, I'm going to select Visual User Interface Testing. And then I'll select Automated Screenshot Testing. I'll then select Automated Screenshot API. The Screenshot Testing API exposes endpoints that we can invoke from a command line or a CI/CD pipeline and generate screenshots programmatically. If I scroll down, I can open the API document. From here, I can select either the Selenium Automation API or the Automated Screenshots API. After selecting the target base URL from this dropdown, I would then select Authorize to enter my LambdaTest account credentials. After pasting in my access key, I would then select Authorize. And as you can see from the confirmation message, I am now authorized. If I scroll to the bottom of the documented endpoints, I can actually start a new screenshot test session. I'll simply select Post, and then I can specify parameters and a request body for this API call. In this case, I'll keep the default values. And then I'll select Try It Out. After selecting Try It Out, I'll leave the default parameters as is, and then I'll select Execute. Doing so will create a new screenshot test session, and you can view not only the curl request making the API call, but also the response from LambdaTest, which includes a test ID. The test ID can be used to fetch the generated screenshots after the test session has been completed. I'm going to copy the test ID to my clipboard. And then I'll scroll up to the Get Screenshots endpoint. And select Get. The Get Screenshots endpoint allows me to download screenshots from a specified test session. We use the test ID to specify which test session we want to download screenshots for. I'll select Try It Out, and then paste the test ID in the test ID field in the parameters. I'll then select Execute. LambdaTest responds with a JSON formatted array of screenshots that were generated in this test session. And we can access and download a particular screenshot using the value of the screenshot URL key. In addition to screenshots, you can also retrieve OS and browser combinations, devices, resolutions, zip screenshots, login profiles, and locations. As you can imagine, this screenshot testing API can be very useful if you have a CI/CD pipeline in which you would like to programmatically trigger screenshot testing on your web application. And using the Get Screenshots endpoint, you can download generated screenshots as pipeline artifacts, whether it be in a Jenkins job, a GitLab pipeline, or another CI/CD tool. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration of the automated screenshot testing feature on the LambdaTest platform. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.